Okay, today we're going to do a super quick tutorial on how to create this knockout kind of look with text. So I'm going to get started, and I'm going to show you guys at the end how you can kind of add it and customize it to on templates and different things like that. So I'm going to get started. So we're going to start with the text tool and go ahead and make it a bit bigger so you can see. Okay, so I've used two different fonts over here. I'm going to show you guys, and I will link the fonts also. Okay, so this font is called Wished, and I'm going to write Mama, and I'm putting it in all caps. Let me see what it looks like in, I don't like that. Okay, if we do all caps, I'm going to make it a little bit larger. Okay, and then you can customize this however you want, like I always say. I'm going to do the text tool again, and I want to write my best friend. Okay, so when you're, for this certain kind of look, you want to find like a scripted font that is kind of like stretched. So I have a font that I really like, and I'll also link that one too. I think it's this one. Okay. So now you can see that this font has these little like tails and flourishes on them. So I'm going to show you guys how to get that. So there's a couple of ways. You can highlight it, and you can have your glyphs pop right up. So I'm going to go ahead and choose that one. Let me make this bigger so you can see. Okay, so this particular font has all of these little options for the D. So let me show you this. So it has that one. It has, oh, that's not the right side. Hold on. It's got that one. It's got that one. That one. Ooh, that's cute. I'm going to stick with that because I feel like that's the easiest look. Actually, I like that one. Okay, and then we're going to go over to the M. And we are going to do the same thing and find an M that we like. I like that one. No, do I? I like that one. Okay, I like that one. Okay, and if you, once you highlight your letters, if the glyphs don't automatically pop up, you can go over here to type and open your glyphs, and then you can literally select any font that you have and click on entire font and see all the different options that those fonts have. Okay. Okay. So, I changed it. Okay. So now I've got this and I've got this, and I want to basically plop that on, and I want to kind of create like a, like kind of like the text is, knocked out in the middle, if that makes sense. Okay. It's early, you guys. Okay. So a couple things to do to prep this. So first of all, when I put this over here, I feel like this is too, like not as like elongated. So two ways to do that. You can hold down shift and just pull it up. Oh no, wait, don't hold down shift. You can pull it up. See how as I do that. So I kind of want to pull it up a tiny little bit. You can do that, or you can go in your characters and you can play with some of these. So I kind of want to bring that up a little bit. I kind of like that. And I clicked on this little thing with the T and the arrow. It's actually called vertical scale. Okay, so I like that. And I'm going to create outlines. And then I'm going to create outlines here. And before you do anything, make sure that you go over to your Pathfinder panel and unite both of the outlines. Okay. Because that is going to make the little pieces connect also. Okay, so now I've got this and I've got this, and I'm gonna change the color so you can see what it looks like. Okay. Oh, I don't like that color. Hold on. Okay, so I wanna put that in between there. So the way I'm gonna do that is I'm going to basically position it where I want it. And I kinda like that. Okay, now I'm gonna copy it, and I'm gonna go to edit, paste in place. So right now there's two of them. So if you look, there's two right here, okay? And I am going to make sure just one of them is selected. Okay, so I'm going to increase my stroke And you can see as I do that, it is getting larger. But see all these little funky jagged edges? That's not very pretty. So the way we're gonna fix that is go over to Window and open your Strokes panel, which is right here, and we're gonna round off the caps, okay? Okay, that's a little too thick, so I'm gonna bring that down to about there, kinda like that. Okay, so now what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to Object, Expand, and now you'll see that it created a path around the outside of that. So we're gonna go over to your Pathfinder and unite it all, and now you see that this little period has funky little holes on there too, so I'm gonna right click it, ungroup it, I'm gonna right click it again, and I'm gonna release the compound path, and now you can see that hole is filled, and we're just gonna unite it. Okay, here is the big one. So make sure that all of your pink is selected. I'm gonna go ahead and make it a compound path, and you could do that by object and compound path make. And I'm gonna make sure that the letters behind it are a compound path also. Make sure that your my best friend text is, or whatever text you chose, is in front, and then select that and select that, the back and the front, and go ahead and minus front. And when you do that, it's gonna give you that look. And I don't really like it because you can see that it didn't really go through the M, so I'm gonna do it again. So I'm going to make sure I have both of them highlighted, and I'm gonna kind of position them a little bit different. How about that? And I'm gonna do my minus front again. Okay, and I like that a little bit better. So at this point, you can basically, you're good to go, and you can engrave that or cut that into whatever you want. But what I'm gonna do is I have a file, let me see. I have a gift tag file that I created a while back, and it's in my shop, and I will post a link for it also. And I'm gonna go, okay, I have it open here. I'm gonna copy this, and I'm gonna show you guys how cute something like this would look on one of these tags. So how fun would this be for Mother's Day? So I'm just gonna put this right off, right in the middle, right in the bottom. I just think that would look pretty with the floral design behind it. And that is good to go. So this is ready for your laser. Actually, I kind of want to group all that together. And I just made that all one compound path, and that's one color. I made this piece right here is a stroke. And so that's going to, I wanna score that, and then I'm gonna cut this outline. So that is good to go.